This video is brought to you by Captivating History. Humans have inhabited Taiwan since around 3000 BCE. It is believed that these people immigrated from Southeast Asia when Taiwan was not yet an island. When sea levels rose and Taiwan became surrounded by water, indigenous tribes populated the island. The Suraya grew rice, sugarcane, and foxtail millets on terraces hewn into the highlands. The Makatao settled the lowlands. The hills and basins were inhabited by the Taivoan, and the Paiwan people lived in the south-central mountainous area. The farms of the Paiwan were designed in concentric circles. The inner ring was for their bamboo and thatch homes, which were built on stilts. The second and third rings were for the families planting and vegetables, and the remainder of the agricultural ground was for communal use. People hunted and fished, with oysters being the most popular dish. The shells were then carved to create cutting tools. The Suraya, who are still around today, are a matriarchal society, with women having once served as priestesses and oracles. A woman's partner would marry into her family after he turned 30 and no longer hunted. Aside from the Tao peoples, a native group living on Orchid Island off the coast of Taiwan, the indigenous Taiwanese practiced headhunting. Raids usually originated from the highlands. Invaders removed the heads of those they slew. They removed the skull, replacing it with a small wooden ball within the skin to keep the shape. The lips were sewn shut, and the flesh would be boiled in water mixed with tannins from plants or oak bark that shrank the skin around the wooden ball. The heads were covered in ash to keep the vengeful soul, called the Muisak, from escaping. The belief was that headhunting reduced the power of the enemy tribe, and the heads were used in religious ceremonies. In the 3rd century CE, there was an influx of people from China. The three kingdoms of China were at war. In 222, the Sun Wu freed themselves from the rule of the Kaowei, and in 230, they arrived on the shores of Taiwan. The Taiwanese started to move away from their beliefs in myths and magic. They looked to the Chinese, referred to by the Taiwanese as the Han people. Confucianism and the cycles of yin and yang appealed to the people of Taiwan, who already lived the cycles of nature through farming, hunting, and fishing. Confucius taught 5 principles: Ren, benevolence; Yi, righteousness; Li, property; Zhi, knowledge; and Xin, integrity. The Han people also brought Taoism to Taiwan. Unrelated to the Tao people, the Tao is a belief in the universe and the oneness of life. Like Confucianism, Taoism is about balance and harmony with nature. Buddhism came to Taiwan during the Ming Dynasty of the 17th century, while the Dutch ruled the island. Buddhism is a religion of enlightenment. The noble truths of Buddhism are that dukkha, suffering, is caused by trishna, earthly desire, and the only end to dukkha is to achieve nirvana. Buddhism grew once the Dutch were ejected and is now the largest religion in Taiwan. Throughout the 1600s, Spanish, Japanese, Chinese, English, and Dutch traders all wanted to colonize Taiwan for trade purposes. In 1622, the Dutch East India Company attempted to establish a post on the Penghu Islands, but was driven off by the Chinese and forced to abandon the area. The Dutch moved south and set up a fort called Fort Zeelandia in the Anping district in 1624. After continued attacks, the Dutch controlled several villages, including Sakam, Sulong, Baklon, and Sinkan. The indigenous people did establish a brief working relationship with the invaders, but it was volatile. Tribes raided each other and still headhunted, while Japanese and Chinese pirates raided the towns on the shoreline. Chinese from the Ming Dynasty went to war with the Dutch, and the native Taiwanese found that those who had allied themselves with the Dutch were at peace. More villages came forward to be under the protection of the Dutch, so that by 1636, the Dutch East India Company controlled the southwest of the island with a peace treaty called Pax Hollandica. The Dutch then started taxing the natives to use the land, resulting in an unsuccessful uprising in 1652 called the Guo Huayi Rebellion. In 1661, a Chinese leader called Zheng Chenggong, better known as Kojinga, led an attack on the prized Dutch Zeelandia area. His attack was a success, and he massacred the Dutch after plowing through their defenses. Seeing the Chinese were winning, the Sakam, Zuland, Baklon, and Sinkan, and other Dutch colonies joined them. The Dutch soldiers that remained alive were holed up in the garrison at Fort Zeelandia for a year. The Dutch misjudged their enemy's ferocity and were forced to abandon the garrison in 1662 after multiple failed retaliations. Koxinga died a few months after he took Fort Zeelandia. He was succeeded by his son Zheng Jing, who wanted to prevent the Qing dynasty from taking over. Thus, education was replaced with military service. Peasants who performed military service were given free ownership of the land they worked. However, they were only able to withstand the might of the Qing dynasty for just over 20 years, and in 1683, they were forced to surrender. Zhuan Yi, the fourth emperor of the Qing dynasty, showed little interest in Taiwan. Ethnic clashes within Taiwan made it difficult to govern, and locals often warred against each other. Despite this, the Chinese continued to move to Taiwan, and by the 19th century, there were 2 million Chinese living in Taiwan. Unlike Zhuan Yi, the Victorian Britain saw strategic value in Taiwan. It was highly accessible by sea, and Britain coveted it as a trading center. Taiwan and China did not place any value in British goods and refused to trade with them. So Britain attempted to corrupt and control the government by smuggling opium from India. In 1839, once China realized what Britain was doing, the First Opium War started. The war lasted until 1842. Britain attacked Hong Kong using warships with guns and cannons, forcing the Chinese to surrender. Britain then was in total control of Hong Kong. In 1856, Britain, France, and Russia attacked the Canton Province, starting the Second Opium War. The Qing dynasty lost the war, and many ports opened up to European countries. Opium was legalized, and the coolie system was introduced. The coolie system meant that Chinese workers could be exported to other countries, like the United States, and paid less than the locals. The promise was that the Chinese would get health benefits in return, but in reality, many of these workers died under terrible conditions while far from home. The French invaded the Taiwanese northern ports of Keelung and Tamsui in 1884. At Tamsui, the battlefield was full of spiny plants, hedges, and ditches that concealed the Chinese warriors, and in October, a huge firefight broke out between the Chinese and the French. Dust and gunpowder filled the air, and French troops were pushed back. In the confusion, the French panicked and continued firing regardless of whether or not there was a target. There could be no call for a ceasefire, as their bugler had been shot. Their ammunition quickly ran low, and they soon had to retreat to their ships. In 1894, Japan and China went to war. Japan was a strong force in China, and by April 1895, the Taiwanese government was forced to sign the Treaty of Shimonoseki, which ceded control of Taiwan to Japan. The people of Taiwan did not take kindly to these new Japanese invaders, and rebellions were frequent. A Robin Hood-like figure called Liao Tianding inspired the locals. He advocated uprising against the Japanese rule, and legends about him sprang up all over Taiwan. In 1895, Goto Shinpei became head of the civilian affairs of Taiwan. He believed to rule a conquered country, you should ingratiate yourself to the population. He replaced the military police force with a civilian recruited one and made the elder Taiwanese statesmen heads of departments. He also attempted to tackle the ongoing issue with opium addiction by restricting its use, although it would not be outlawed until the mid-1940s. Goto also wanted to stabilize Taiwanese currency to encourage investment, and he set up the Bank of Taiwan in 1897. In 1912, with the Japanese still in control of Taiwan, Chinese revolutionaries overthrew the last Chinese dynasty and established the Republic of China. During World War I, 1914 to 1918, China and Japan supported the Allied powers. In 1915, with the world gripped in its First World War, the native Taiwanese rebelled against the immigrant population and their Japanese overlords. Called the Tapani Incident, the rebels felt that violence was needed to trigger a new age of peace and harmony in Taiwan, free from corrupt and greedy leadership. When World War I ended in 1918, Taiwan's economy was stimulated. Money poured in and education increased. Social reform took place and new business and private enterprises blossomed. But things did not go so well for the indigenous population. In 1930, the Japanese government confiscated farmland from the Taiwanese natives, selling their men into slavery. The Association of Aboriginal People rebelled, killing 130 Japanese soldiers. Illegal land sales to the Han Chinese made it increasingly difficult for the Aboriginal people to continue to support themselves and their families. Finally, in 1935, Taiwanese nationalists won the majority in an election, and Taiwan gained representation in Japan. In 1939, World War II began, and Japan sided with Germany and Italy. China has joined the Allied forces of the Soviet Union, Great Britain, and the United States. America sent aid to China to bolster its defenses against Japan, and Japan turned to Taiwan for manpower and manufacturing. A well-known unit of Aboriginal tribes, called the Takasago Volunteers, fought in the Philippines, the Dutch East Indies, the Solomon Islands, and New Guinea. They were accustomed to the subtropical climate and were a tremendous asset to the Japanese. In 1944, the United States and Japan battled in South Japan, with fighter planes flying over Taiwan both day and night. In 1951, 49 Allied nations signed the Treaty of San Francisco. Japan was required to give up its control of areas outside Japan, including Taiwan. The treaty left Taiwan's status as a country rather vague, as the sovereignty of Taiwan was ceded to no one. China had already formed the Taiwan Provincial Administrative Office in 1945 and started the process of taking over Taiwan on behalf of the Allies. Chen Yi was appointed chief executive of the Taiwan province, and corruption crept in. It was soon widespread, and Taiwan's economy took a nosedive. The unemployment issues worsened when Chinese nationals moved to the country, taking jobs. In 1946, Chen Yi tightened his grip, and many industries were strictly controlled. On February 4, 1947, a woman named Lin was selling contraband cigarettes and was beaten to death in front of a crowd of onlookers. The following day, the Taiwanese staged a peaceful protest. But when four protesters were killed without warning, the protest quickly became violent. Protesters took over the administration of Taipei, broadcasting demands for autonomy over the local radio. The rebellion spread, and Chen Yi called in troops from China. Bodies of an estimated 5,000 to 28,000 people littered the streets, and executions resulted in a further 3,000 deaths. When the American ambassador discovered what had happened, Chen was dismissed. In 1949, martial law was declared in Taiwan, lasting until 1987. Groups supporting Taiwan's independence were persecuted or imprisoned for alleged communist ties. By 1979, the U.S. was committed to maintaining peace in the Western Pacific and signed the Taiwanese Relations Act. It declared protection for Taiwan and would not recognize the domination of China over Taiwan. Taiwan still pushed for sovereignty, and in 1987, the common people were granted equal rights and could apply for government positions regardless of their political alliance. With martial law lifted, political liberalization and civil rights groups flourished. A national movement, called Taiwanization, started to celebrate the distinct identity of the Taiwanese people, separate from the Chinese or Japanese. In 1989, students of Taiwan University traveled to Beijing to stage pro-democracy protests. The Chinese Communist Party saw these protests as a threat to the government, declared martial law, and sent in tanks. Troops fired indiscriminately and massacred hundreds of people in Tiananmen Square. On June 5, 1990, an infamous incident occurred in which a young man stood down a large tank. He climbed onto the tank and spoke to the driver, causing it to veer out of the column. The man was later identified as 19-year-old Wang Weilin, although the newspaper was not entirely sure of his identity. Police removed him, and his fate is unknown, but he remains a hero of democracy. Today, Taiwan's political status is as ambiguous as ever. It is officially called the Republic of China, but it is inhabited by many ethnic groups. It is torn between unification and independence. Beyond this, it is clear that the Taiwanese are intelligent and hardworking, a haven for artists, poets, and political scientists. Taiwan has been referred to as an evolving democracy. Whatever is in store for Taiwan in the future, you can be sure that they will face it with a loyal and fierce spirit. To learn more about the history of Taiwan, check out our book, History of Taiwan: A Captivating Guide to Taiwanese History and the Relationship with the People's Republic of China. It's available as an ebook, paperback, and audiobook. Also, grab your free Mythology Bundle ebook while it's still available. All links are in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos like this.